A very good morning, students. Welcome to your EVS class. Hope you all are fine, healthy, and you must be staying at your homes these days. Students, it's very difficult to stay locked in your houses until or unless you are with your family, right? What makes us comfortable? This is the most comfortable thing. Whenever a person is with family, the person feels safe, secure, comfortable. So, today our topic of discussion is my family. You are already done with this chapter, but I'll make you revise with the few most important things so that you can revise it and prepare it for your upcoming exams. So, let's begin. As we are talking about the family, so first of all, you all should know what is a family. When a group of people live together under a same roof, or you can say in a house, in a same house, this is known as a family. And you can say when few persons live together and they are connected with each other by any relation, they are known as family. So families basically are of different kinds. As you could have a big family, a small family, there it depends on the number of persons living in that family. In a family, the most important persons in anyone can found is the parents. Parents are mother and father, both they are known as together parents. One of them is known as parent, and if I'm talking about mother and father both, the word which I use for them is parents. So the most important persons we find around ourselves is parents. They love us unconditionally. They help us to know about the world. They help us to teach, to learn new things. So they help us to know everything, what is wrong for us, what is right for us. And they help us in getting everything which is essential for us, like our food. They take care of our daily needs. So parents do so many things for us. We should always thank them. We should respect them. So beside those parents, if in a family, suppose in a family, the parent and the children live. Look at this picture. This is a type of family known as nuclear family, which is nowadays mostly in trend. Most of the families are living separately, that only parents and children live in a house. These types of families are known as nuclear families, or we call them small families, because very less persons are living here in this family. So we call them a small family. So generally it has parents, that means two persons, and two siblings, two children basically. So this is known as nuclear family. So generally we consider four members in a nuclear family. Let's discuss the another type of family, that is, as the picture depicts us, more members are here, and in this you can see the parents, children, as well as grandparents. This is known as big family, or we call it a joint family. A joint family not only has grandparents, parents, children, but also they have uncles, aunts, and cousins living together in a same house. Who are cousins? Do you know who are cousins? The children of our uncles and aunts are known as our cousins. And when we talk about uncle and aunts, they can be in relation to our mother as well as our father. Let me tell you one more interesting thing. Suppose I'm talking about my mama's family. They are known as my maternal relatives. Maternal relatives. And if I'm talking about my papa's family, they are known as paternal family. So we do have these two types of families. If I'm talking about my dadi, dada, chacha, chachi, bua, they are my paternal relatives. So basically they are uncles and aunts. If I'm talking about bua, chacha, chachi, they are my uncle and aunt, but paternal family. And if I talk about mama, mami, mausa, mausi, unke bare mein if we are talking, they are our maternal families. So, but both of them, if I'm talking about any of them, they must be our uncles and aunts, and their children are known as our cousins. And with the word cousins, we never use cousin brother, cousin sister. No, we simply say he is my cousin, she is my cousin. This is the common word which we use for a boy or as well as for a girl. Cousin. The spelling of cousin is C-O-U-S-I-N. Cousin. Make sure you learn these spellings as well. Spelling of joint family, spelling of nuclear family. Whenever we come across new words, we always should write them in a separate notebook so many times so that we should learn the spellings properly. So here with the picture at the top, this line reveals us a family is a group of people who are related to each other and who lives together. This is the definition of a family. So I have told you there are two types of families which we have discussed, joint family, nuclear family. Let me tell you one more interesting thing. We all do have separate names. We do have unique names, separate names. But there is certain thing which we do have common with our family members. What is that? That is known as family name, or we call it surname. Every family has one last name which is same for all members. It is called a family name or surname. That means if anyone has a name like Akshit, Manan, whatever is the name, but if they belong to the same family, they will use the same family name. Here are few examples given to us for the family names. Sharma, Singh, Khan, Arora are some common surnames we can find. So basically we do have surnames as well. We call it like if I write my name, Kanika Haseeja. Kanika is my first name and Haseeja is my family name. That is my surname. So you should also know what is surname. I hope you are clear with it. You must be knowing your surname as well. Every one of you. So we have discussed about types of families as well as the surname. Now, what is the importance of a family? Why family is important? It gives us love, protection and comfort. As I told you in the beginning, it gives us love, protection and comfort. We feel very safe and protected when we are with our family. It gives us food, clothes, home and care. Obviously, all the essentials which I told you. It gives us, our family takes care of us whenever we are sad or sick. But what makes something more interesting when we are living in a family? We can share our work, our secrets, our thoughts, our ideas. We can exchange everything what we feel with our family members without any fear, without any hesitation. So family is very, very important. We can talk to them about anything what we feel and it helps us to grow properly mentally. And a family gives us love and respect. We should also love and respect our family. When our family, our parents, our grandparents are giving us so many things, like they are providing us food, clothes, education, whatever. They are providing us almost everything. They are giving their time to us. They are fulfilling all our demands. So in return, what we people as kids can give? We can give love and respect to our family. So I think you all must be in a habit of respecting and loving your family members. Respect can be shown in your gestures, in your words, in your feelings. You can express your feelings to them. You can wish them well. Say good morning, good afternoon, good night to your parents, to your grandparents and whosoever is there in your family. You can wish them well. You can respect them well. And whenever you find them that they are not well or they are tired, sometimes you can also ask for a help. A help can be like if you fetch a glass of water for your mama when she is tired. She will really like it. So you can share your work with your family members also. When they help you in your work, you can also help them in their work. If anyone is watering the garden plants, you can also help them in that one. You can also help in fetching things like newspaper or spectacles for your grandparents, whatever. So make these good habits, make it your habit and just respect and love your family. So this is all about the chapter, My Family. Hope you are clear with it. You need to go through it. Just read the chapter thoroughly so that you become a more and more clear with the topics which you have read. If you still find any doubt, just underline that word, think about that, or you may contact me for anything. हैव अ गुड डे स्टूडेंट्स।